Welcome to this programming screencast on PageRank using points distribution method. So before getting into the points distribution method, actually we'll revisit some concepts from the previous weeks, as well as we'll see some prerequisites that would help you understand the points distribution method better. So we'll get started. First we'll go with a revision. So we had seen a data structure called graphs when we had seen the concept of 6 degrees of separation. Using the Facebook data set, we had analyzed that between two people, what is the distance you can reach. We had analyzed there, we had taken a data structure called graph through which the Facebook friendship network is modeled. So we had seen about it. So while explaining about graphs, I had taken railway networks as an example. So here is a network that we had taken. So here the graph is nothing but a set of points and lines. Points are technically called as nodes and lines are technically called as edges. So in this railway network, we had the cities or the railway stations, the stations as nodes, and there is an edge, there is a line between the two nodes. If there is a direct train from this city to that city, that's how we had taken the net, we had modeled and we had created a network, we had created a graph. So this is a graph. So nodes and edges are the terminologies I would like you guys to recall. And another thing that we had seen is neighbors. Neighbors are nothing but what are all the nodes? A particular node is connected to using an edge. That's what we call as a neighbor. For example, if you take this node Kolkata, the neighbors are Guwahati, Bengaluru and Chennai. The node Chennai has two neighbors, Bengaluru and Kolkata. So this is what you call as neighbors. And whatever we have, this network is what is an undirected graph. That is, there is no direction. The edges are bidirectional, we assume. That is, if there is a train from Chennai to Bengaluru, there is another train from Bengaluru to Chennai as well. That is an assumption we have. That's how our Indian railway network in major cities is. That's an assumption we had made. But it's not the case always that this kind of a representation is enough to represent any data. Sometimes we may need to consider the directions as well. So we'll see an example of such networks in this lecture as a new concept. So such graphs are what we call as directed graphs. So here is a directed graph where the direction of edges, that is from which node to which node, is the connection present. This direction information is also important in a directed graph. An example from the real world that we can take is, as I have given in the slide, it's email communication network. So here the nodes are the different email IDs, the different people or their email IDs, and there is an edge from one node to another node if this email ID has sent a mail to another one. That is, see in this network there are, let us take a very small group, there are three email IDs we had taken, A, B and C, and generally we keep them anonymized, right? That's why we'll take a toy example A, B and C. Let's say there are some three nodes. So the from this mail ID there is a mail that is sent to this mail ID A to B, there is an edge. So person A has sent a mail to person B, but it's not necessary that person B should reply. So that's why we don't have a back edge, an edge from B to A, whereas the mail he has sent to C, C has replied. So if you have sent a mail from this person to that person, you have a directed edge. The direction denotes who has received the mail. So from A, B has received. So there is an arrow towards B. This is how the email communication network can be constructed. So the point to note here is you have directed edges. The direction of the edges is very important in these directed graphs. And some other examples that we can consider is maybe from the academics, the academia, I can say citation network. We have something called citation network where the nodes are the research paper. And if one paper is citing or it is referring to another research paper, there will be a directed edge. And as you could understand, it's not necessary that the edge has to be bidirectional. Say for example, you may cite a paper that has been written in say 2005. It is not necessary that that paper, that authors should cite you back in some other paper or in that same paper. So it's a directed edge, right? So you understand the concept of directed edges. This is from academia. And another example of a social network, just like Facebook, something involving people, that could be something like you can have people as nodes, and if this person likes another person, if your person A likes person B, there is a directed edge from A to B. So this person has expressed a liking for this person. This could be used in, for example, matrimonial sites. You can use it, you can make analysis of matrimonial sites and you can suggest better recommendations. There are a lot of applications which can be easily solved if you model the data as a graph, especially as a directed graph. This is one thing, an example of social networks. Maybe another example, if you want to give, I may give from the marketing domain. The marketing domain, we have something called the supply chain network. So basically, the different companies are the nodes here. And if this company supplies some material to this company, there is a directed edge. So basically, let us see this company B. In that case, company B is acquiring some raw materials from company A, and it is making some products and it is selling those products, it is supplying those products to company C, something like this. So for example, if B, let's say battery, if this company is manufacturing batteries, the raw materials needed, the electrolytes, the lithium rods, all those such raw materials, it will acquire from different companies. So they will be the incoming edges. So it is acquiring the raw materials from different companies. And once it has manufactured the batteries may be of different requirement. The one you use it for your television remote, the one for your clock, the one for your car, everything. The batteries are different. So this may manufacture batteries using these raw materials, and the manufactured products are sold to different other companies. So the car batteries would be sold to the major car companies, and the clock batteries to the clock manufacturers, and so on. So this is how you can form a network using the different companies and the transactions they have. Such a network is called a supply chain network. This would be a directed graph. And I don't think there will be a bidirectional edge in supply chain network, although I'm not a marketing expert. This is just a little knowledge that I have. But maybe if you feel that there are some examples where there can be bidirectional edge in a supply chain network also, please do let us know in the discussion forum. Like this, yeah, the motto here is to make you understand that there would be directed edges, and what do the directed edges signify in different networks. We have taken one example of email communication network. It can be WhatsApp communication. Someone has messaged you on WhatsApp. There is a directed edge from that person to you. If you reply back, you'll get a back edge. If you don't reply, you won't get a back edge. So that can be WhatsApp communication network, mail communication network, anything, a communication network in general. Or in academia, you have the citation network. And in marketing domain, we have the supply chain network. In case of social networks, you can consider it as sort of matrimonial networks, like which person has contacted which person, based on that, whether the person has replied back to his profile, something like that. You can construct it as a network and you can perform analytics. Once you have modeled your data in the form of a graph data structure, analytics is very easy further. So that's why there are many applications where this graph data structure, the directed graph especially, comes very useful. So we'll get into some terminologies of the directed graphs as well. So the edges we have, right? So we will have other names as well. Nodes, as I had said, is points, and edges are lines, is the layman terms. Other technical names can also be present. That is, nodes can also be called as vertices, and edges can also be called as links. I'm just telling because maybe in our lectures we may use those terms interchangeably, or maybe if you look up to some material online, some research papers or some textbooks, you look up anywhere, these two terms may be used interchangeably. Nodes or vertices, and edges or links, they may be used interchangeably. And let us see some terminologies. So the links or the edges, in case of an undirected graph, they are bidirectional. So we just say they are the edges, but here it's a directed graph, so the direction matters. So we will say incoming links and outgoing links, incoming edges and outgoing links. and outgoing edges. So for node in this graph, if you consider, for node A, the incoming edge is from C to A. That's why we have a tuple C, A. And the outgoing edge is from A to B and A to C. Like this, you can say the outgoing links and incoming links. So the representation is source, target. Source is the starting point and target is the destination or the end point of that edge. An edge is present between two nodes. The starting point is called the source, that will be given as the first item here, and the end point of the edge is the target, that is given as the second item of the tuple. So like this, edges will be denoted by tuples. This is the representation regarding directed graphs. Alright, so I have started off with directed graphs. So I would like that you guys think of any other applications where this directed graphs can come handy. So that would be the thing I would expect you guys as a result of watching this video. You must think in that direction, and we'll see further prerequisites in the upcoming parts.